All right, what's up, guys? I think you can see us. Real quick, me and Mike are going to do a quick two-minute video about the moment arm. As simple as I can make it, the moment arm is the distance from the joint and to the resistance. Meaning, if Mike's sitting here and he puts his arm out to the side, pretend he's doing lateral raises. Doesn't matter what you're doing. You have a moment arm and everything. This is his joint or his fulcrum. The resistance for now will be my hand. So the distance from those two points is the moment arm. A long moment arm becomes a weak moment arm. Meaning, if I tell Mike to push up, as I try to push him down, I'm obviously going to win, and I know I have leverage. Even if I use two fingers, I can win, because he has a long moment arm. However, if I flex his elbow, his moment arm went from this distance to half of that distance. Now I'm going to tell him to stop me again. He's much stronger, twice as strong, actually. So it's simple physics. If you have trouble doing pull-ups and you're real long and skinny, it's because your moment arm is longer, your arm is longer, so the distance you have to travel to complete the chin-up makes it harder. Or if you're heavier, if you're a big, strong guy, you can deadlift 800 pounds, but you're 300 pounds yourself, you probably don't do chin-ups well because you're heavy. You're heavy, and simple physics says you will not move your mass well. But the moment arm is in every single thing we do. Longer moment arms make you weaker. It's not good or bad, it's just relative to your body weight or your length. So it's just something you should think about when you're in the gym. Give it a shot.